All right. Sizes of your atoms on the periodic table. This is negating your transition metals. Going from left to right, your atoms are going to decrease in size.
Left to right
is going to decrease.
Oh, yeah.
Going from top to bottom, the size is going to get bigger. Okay. Now, can we use effective nuclear charge to explain the size difference?
Yes. Yeah.
How? Tell me.
Electrons.
Remember, what is my effective nuclear charge?
The nucleus can hold
electrons in. There you go. So now, can we explain what is happening here using effective nuclear charge?
When you make goes left to right, nucleus has more electrons to attract.
So the effective nuclear charge increases.
So and when it goes top to bottom, it feels like more shell, right?
Don't say shells.
What is it?
Again, we're still staying with the effective nuclear charge. We're using the effective nuclear charge to explain this strength.
Okay, this strength because I'm
going from left to right. The effective nuclear charge
is increasing.
Going from top to bottom.
It's decreasing. Oh, that's
more. Okay, that's it. Mm-hmm. So as the effective nuclear charge increases, the size will decrease. As the effective nuclear charge decreases, the size will increase. Do we get that? What'd you say, honey?
No,
he said. Okay. Alright. Take a question. Okay? Remember the trend. Top to bottom is bigger.
Size
is bigger. So left to right, size gets smaller. Okay? Arrange sodium, beryllium, and magnesium in order of increasing atomic radii. So I want my biggest one on my right hand side.
Atomic radius means the size, bigger size, right?
Bigger size.
Beryllium, sodium, magnesium.
Beryllium.
Sodium.
Sodium.
Magnesium.
From top to bottom, it decreases.
My answer, I want my biggest.
left to right is smaller? Decreasing in size?
For which one are you talking about? On the periodic table?
Yeah. Yeah.
The periodic table, left to... Oh, no, boy, I don't know.
Teeth, you are current!
So, on the periodic table...
I should crawl on the floor to you!
Left to right decreases. Top to bottom increases on the periodic table.
Oh, so now you're just abandoning.
Yeah, the last one.
Right?
The last one.
So we have two new ones.
The last one.
Which one do you choose?
I don't know.
Who's magnesium?
Magnesium is after the sodium.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's small.
Yeah.
So are we in agreement?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Ronnie, what you think?
Vote for third.
Yeah, third.
It depends
so
on how you look at it. Magnesium is smaller, right?
Yeah, because it goes the third way.
Iman, what you think?
Vote for third.
Look at my heart, you're trying to recruit people.
Huh?
You get it?
No, you don't understand the question?
No.
I want you to tell me which of these three is the largest. Based on the trends of the size on the periodic table, which of these is the largest, which is the smallest, which is in the middle?
First one is BE, right?
What's BE?
Yes.
Think about the periodic table and how things are set up.
12 times? No, it's not that because it's going to left to right. Sodium to magnesium? It's left to right. The sodium is bigger than the magnesium.
So there's 12 times of magnesium and 11 times of sodium.
No,
what?
When it's in the last pill, it's one liquid.
There's not 11 types of magnesium now.
Right, 11 types. 11 times.
11 times?
11
moles
of.
No, it's electron. That's atomic number.
That is the atomic number.
Okay. It's not the moon. Oh, I thought it was the moon.
Iridium, magnesium, and sodium.
We vote.
They're minus two.
Yes, we won.
Okay, so let's try another one. Do we understand why it's set up this way?
Yes.
Okay. So, now the sizes for your ions, Beth. Okay? Bring it home. We going back to Mama Hen. Okay? Now, Mama Hen, I have my 17-year-old. I have a 10-year-old and I have a 1-year-old. Okay?
Really?
Now, how exactly, what is my reach on my 17-year-old? Mama Hen.
Strong.
Strong. So, what's going to happen to my size? I'm going to pull it in so I won't get smaller. Right? So, if you have a metal. What needs to happen for your metal to become an anion? It has to lose electrons. Okay? So, oh, I lied. Sorry. My cat ion. Thank you. Okay? You got me. Okay? Alright. So, let's say I need attention. I need attention. Okay? So, let's say my 17-year-old pick up themselves, go outside, get shot and killed.
What the?
I just lost my electron. I just lost my baby. Right? Now, what is going to happen with my 10-year-old?
He's not going outside.
He ain't going outside. I'm going to grab him and pull him in.
More strongly.
Okay? So there goes my effective nuclear charge. Increases. Okay? So now, you see that line, right? Good, right? So, let's say now, my 17-year-old come back to life. I'm kind of busy. Like, I got, you know, everything here, this here. Okay? So now, what is now going to happen to my size?
Bigger.
I'm going to get bigger. Because now my reach, I can't reach my 17-year-old now. So now, what does that translate to? I have just added another mouth to feed. So what does that translate to?
Cation.
I have added.
Oh. And anion is
bigger.
Yeah,
of course.
Is that what you're trying to say?
Yeah.
Is that what you're trying to say?
No. What I'm trying to say is what is happening. I have added another child to me.
Mm-hmm. When you add an electron, you get bigger. When you lose, you get smaller.
There you go. You've added another electron when you are an anion. That means your effective nuclear charge is going to decrease. Your repulsion is going to increase, so therefore your size is going to increase. Do we get that?
Can you just...
Can I just what?
Say that one more time.
All right. So, I have a 17-year-old pick me, a 10-year-old pick me, 1-month-old pick me, a 3-month-old pick me.
Four of them.
Okay? We never had four of them before we had three. Alright? So now, how much of a say I can have in my 17-year-old life?
With all of those
kids. With all these pick me.
Not much.
So therefore, what's my reach going to be now?
For the bigger, because it's going further to get to.
Exactly. So what's now happening to my size?
You're gonna get bigger.
I'm going to get bigger. So now what is going to happen to an anion, a non-metal, when you add an electron to it? It's going to get bigger.
Yeah.
Do we get that?
Yes.
Yes.
So how does the effective nuclear charge come in?
If you are getting bigger, remember, what is the effective nuclear charge?
That's the same you have on your children?
That's the same, that's that pull.
Okay, so all the pigment that you can are just pulled
out. You can't pull no pigment with a 3-month old right here.
Alright, cool.
Okay? Alright, so here's what happens. Okay? When you have a cation, you are going to lose your electrons. If you lose the electrons, your effective nuclear charge increases, so therefore your size will decrease. The trend holds true going from left to right. Your size of your ions will decrease according to the same size of your neutral element. Following the same trend, going from top to bottom, the size will still increase. The same way it increases with your neutral element.
Yeah.
We get that? Now with your non-metals, when you are forming your anions, you are adding electrons to it, therefore you are increasing repulsion and decreasing your effective nuclear charge, so your anions become bigger. And again, the trend still holds. Going from top to bottom, they will get bigger. Going from left to right.
They look the same size as me.
They kind of do look the same size, but we're going to work on from top to bottom. Okay? So we going to get that? Did we get that?
Yeah.
Okay. Huh?
No.
Okay. Don't worry left to right. Worry top to bottom. Okay? Alright. So we also have something called isoelectronic ions. Alright? Isoelectronic ions simply means that you have the same electronic configuration. Okay? But please sing for me the electronic configuration for neon.
Neon.
1s2.
1s2.
2s2.
2s2.
4p6.
2p6.
Thank you. 2p6. You lose electrons. What does magnesium have to do in order to form its cation? Where are these electrons going to come from?
3s2.
3s2. So please, write for me.
Wait, why are you giving up the good shoes?
S is not good shoes.
No,
S, that ain't good shoes.
Okay, you got a two. Wait.
React with that. Because the only time it makes a difference is when we got the red bottoms and the Lord of Taylors.
That's just the D's and the P's.
The D's and the S's. The D's and the four S's.
So you would want to keep your D's and your four S's.
Right.
And give up your two P's.
The S's, you give up the S's first. You must always give up your S's first before you give up anything else.
True.
See now, in order to give up my one S, okay, you got my 17-year-old, my 10-year-old, my 1-year-old, the one S, that's my eggs. Like you can't get that far.
So you have to go all the way in the closet to get
right. That's all the way in there. Like you can't mess with that close. Like you too close right there.
Except hydrogen.
Okay. Huh?
Except hydrogen.
Now hydrogen is special. He's different. He does what he wants. Okay.
Always.
All right. Please sing for me my electronic configuration for magnesium 2+.
1s2 2s2 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 2s2
seeing the electronic configuration for fluorine minus. This means that these two ions are isoelectronic with neon. So they have the same configuration as neon.
So it means they can never bond like that?
No. This allows them to bond. Because they're ions, this allows them to bond.
But, alright, so what is the whole isoelectronic attribute? It just means that all of their electrons?
Yes. Do we get that?
Yes.
Okay.
What about the size?
We ain't worried about them sizes yet. Okay? Now, here we go. Here's a question for you. We're going to mix it up. Arrange magnesium 2 plus, calcium 2 plus, and calcium in order of decreasing radius. So I want my smallest one on my right hand side.
Oh, okay.
Magnesium.
They would have calcium 2 plus.
No.
You want
what? You want
this?
No, you want
the small one. Is this side?
You said, or from
small one is on this side.
Okay.
So
small one,
right side.
Right side.
Magnesium 2 plus.
You have calcium.
Calcium 2 plus.
Yeah.
No, you have calcium first.
Magnesium 2 plus.
On the right hand side.
No, the left.
He said magnesium 2 plus is on the right hand side.
Yeah, he's right.
It's the smallest one, right?
That you said smallest one is on this side. I want decreasing radius.
Okay.
Smallest
on the right side.
Calcium 2 plus.
Left side will be calcium 2 plus.
Calcium 2 plus.
All the left is calcium.
Calcium 2 plus is in the middle.
No, calcium 2 plus is in the middle.
Yeah.
And calcium 2 plus.
All the way is calcium.
Yeah, this side.
Are we in agreement?
Yes.
We sure?
Yeah, both of that.
Wait, hold up.
That's what I like to do. Do we understand why that is?
Yes.
Where is calcium and magnesium in relation to each other?
Right above each other.
Huh?
On second row.
So they're on top of each other. Who's on top?
Magnesium.
Magnesium is on top. Alright? So what does that tell you about magnesium, the neutral element magnesium? It's smaller than
calcium.
Oh, now
calcium.
We're looking from top to bottom.
Yes, we're looking top to bottom. OK? Okay.
How do you know which one to look from?
Say it again.
How do you know which way to look?
It's how they're set up on the periodic table. How they're set up on the periodic table will never change.
Yeah, but with the other one, we're looking from left to right.
We know we didn't only look from left to right. We look from top to bottom, left to right.
Okay.
Okay. So, what happens when you form the ions?
They get smaller.
They get smaller. So if they get
cations.
When they get smaller, the trend still holds. So your magnesium will still be smaller than your calcium.
From left to right, isn't it bigger though?
But they're no, left to right is smaller.
Is from left?
Left to right.
Left is bigger, no? This side is bigger to that.
Yes.
But magnesium is bigger from going from that way.
No. Magnesium is on top of calcium.
Lithium is bigger than neon.
Oh, we're doing it that way.
Yes.
But if we're doing it, oh, you don't do it. Okay.
But don't take into consideration noble gases. Noble gases, again.
I'm not supposed to take into consideration the weight either, right?
No.
See,
yes.
Isn't it easy to think like that? Is magnesium 2 plus is the argon and neon?
No. Noble gases. Noble gases. We're not factoring noble gases into this at all.
Okay.
Right? I keep thinking that's a rat.
So
if y'all see me screaming, head out of here, that's because I keep thinking that's a rat.
Left to right, big to small.
Yes. Here's another one for you. Which of the following atoms or ions is the largest? I want one answer.
S.
Which is
S.
The largest?
S.
That's 2 minus.
S2
I agree
minus.
That.
Well, S is on the bottom of oxygen.
Uh-huh.
And it's adding 2 electrons.
Uh-huh.
Just as the big ones.
There you go. So, sulfur is below oxygen. So, we already know that sulfur is going to be bigger than oxygen. So, you're adding 2 electrons to sulfur, you're adding 2 electrons to oxygen. Sulfur is still going to be bigger than oxygen. Oxygen 2 minus, yes.
So, alright, lithium is bigger than oxygen, right?
Yes.
Yeah. Lithium still bigger than O, oxygen 2 minus?
We don't.
Because you said anions are bigger than. Cations.
Right.
What?
But we compare anions with anions, cations with cations.
Oh, so you're not really gonna ask us to like just
no. Not mix it much. That's what I got too. Okay. Now, electronic configuration. We did this already. Right? When you're making your ions, if you have a cation, you're going to subtract that many, the number of electrons according to its charge. And you're going to write the electronic configuration the same way. If you have an anion, whatever the charge is, you're going to add that many electrons and then continue writing on the same way. We did that already. Okay? Do we get that?
Yes.
Okay. Now here we go. I want a couple things from you. Write me the electronic configuration of the following ions and determine its isoelectronic element.
What?
So,
calcium plus?
Yes. So write it out for me.
Why?
So the electronic configuration for calcium 2 plus. Sing it out.
1s2,
2s2,
2p6,
3s2,
3p6,
and it's isoelectronic with argon?
Yes.
For calcium?
Calcium 2 plus.
It's for the cobalt
3s2.
Cobalt 3 plus.
1s2.
1s2.
2s2,
2p6, 3 p 6
4 s 2
4 s 1
but
yes
this
4 s 1
yes 4 s 1
yes
6 b
yeah
okay that
4 s
let's bring it home let's do cobalt itself
yeah 4 s 2
4 s 2
4 t d
7 3d7 okay
we don't put the 4s2 for calcium because it's plus 2 right
so it's going to be 3d6
yes
so we're taking away that 2
yes
okay.
3d6
calcium 2 plus is isoelectronical argon
yes
because it landed on argon
no because you have this is the electronic configuration
for argon.
So now, if you are removing, so what do you need to do with cobalt?
Was that cobalt 3 minus?
Cobalt 3 plus.
Take away 2, 3,
you know? No, you take away 3 electrons. Where's the electrons coming from?
4s
and 3d. So cobalt 3 plus. Sing it out.
1s and 2.
2s, 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 2s,
three D's. You can take away all of your four S, and then you hit your three D's. Yeah.
But previous class, like previous class, we hear about that it's gonna be like have 1-1-1 in the box.
No, it can't be 1-1-1.
Because yeah.
It's gonna be six.
Wow.
So it's five, and then one is doubled up.
Okay. Please just follow that rule.
What rule?
Like in 6B, the chromium. Yeah. In the chromium, we have like the 4S1 and 3D5.
Yes.
So it has the same amount when it's cobalt 3 plus, same electron level.
So.
So it's not 6B, because. Like chromium have the
24 electron.
It has like 24 electrons.
So electron.
So cobalt 27. When he's got 3 electrons, it has 24 again.
Yes.
So it's not similar to chromium. Because chromium.
This is isoelectronic with what?
Iron.
No, chromium.
Iron.
Chromium.
But chromium has the 4s1 3d5. That's my question.
Right, but it has the same number of electrons. So nobody will really. What, give me something that will have this type of electronic configuration.
It's probably...
Whoa.
I don't understand the question. Did you just say iron? No, iron. Iron is not
3D. It's 4S. Iron is 2 plus. Or 3 plus.
Iron 3 minus? Oh, no, no.
Iron 3 plus, or 2 plus.
Have you?
Iron is what again?
2 plus or 3 plus? Right?
No,
four
iron
S
is...
3D.
Is,
five,
I, is
six.
Argon?
3S2.
3. 4S2.
Argon 4S2.
No, 4S2.
3D.
3D6?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So... this would be isoelectronic with?
Yeah.
Argon. Iron?
No. Iron what?
Iron 2 plus.
2 plus?
2 plus?
2 minus?
Yeah, 2 plus.
Iron 2 plus. Do you get that?
Mm-hmm. I thought, alright.
Wait.
You give away the
what?
S first,
iron.
Right? When you're giving away shoes?
Yes.
Oh, so it's going to become better.
So it would be your S, then your P, then your D?
Iron.
When you're giving away shoes, it'll be the S.
It depends though.
A plus.
So, where do you lose electrons from?
S.
No. Give me in general.
From the.
Starts with a V. Your valence shell. Where's your valence shell?
The outermost. No.
The outermost, but how do we recognize the outermost electron shell?
Oh.
The biggest? The last one? last, it's the top, the biggest, the highest.
The highest one. So now, here, where's the highest shell?
4s.
So therefore, where are you losing electrons from first?
4s.
4s first. When you get rid of 4s, where are you going to lose electrons from then? Who is the highest one?
3.
3. Who comes in? Who comes before in
3p?
3d. 3d comes first. So you're going to lose from 3d. Then you can lose from 3p. Then if you lost from 3p and you still have more to lose, where are you going to lose it from?
3s.
3s. If you get rid of 3s, where are you going to lose it from then?
2p.
So it's always the highest one, the highest shell and the highest orbital, that's the one you're losing electrons.
So in this case, 3s, 2, 3p, 6, and 3d.
What?
This? Like the cobalt. Okay, the cobalt.
Yes?
So in cobalt, 2, we gave away.
Okay, so here the most expensive one is 3s, 2. Like if you want to take out the, like, give out the electron. So first we
no, no, no. 3D. If you have this, you already lost your 4s, so you're going to have to lose from your 3d first.
It is not 3s.
Sulfur, 2 minus.
1s2.
2s2. 1s2.
2s2.
2s2.
2p6.
2p6.
3s2.
3s2.
3p6.
3p6.
Yeah.
Oh. My head is acting up again. Like I can't.
So we put what it lands on. Okay.
Yes.
Before we were putting the noble gas. Now we're putting what it lands on.
Yes.
How do we know the difference when they ask the question?
It will ask you what is iso. What is it isoelectronic with?
Element.
Yes.
And what's the other one? When you're just putting the when it asks for the noble gas.
Yes.
Then you okay.
You get that?